Welcome to our training on best practices for using Product Opportunity Explorer. In this video, we'll cover some specific strategies you can use to find relevant opportunities for your business through Product Opportunity Explorer. Product Opportunity Explorer helps Amazon sellers generate new catalog ideas by better understanding customer demand. By analyzing Opportunity Explorer data, you can identify high potential areas where customer demand is unmet and fill these gaps with new products and offers. You can use the tool to understand current supply, project sales potential, and conduct product research. You can also use it to plan a product launch and go-to-market strategy and evaluate search terms for detail page and ad campaign optimization. To find the tool, open the Seller Central main menu, hover over Growth, and select Product Opportunity Explorer. The Opportunity Explorer can help with a top-down research strategy when you don't have a specific idea in mind. Start by navigating to the tool, selecting Find Opportunities by Categories, and choosing the most relevant category or subcategory. Next, sort the category to get a better overall sense of it, and filter your results with a combination of filters to match your goals. Sorting niches can give you a better sense of the higher and lower ranges of metrics in a category and the category overall. A niche is a collection of customer search terms and products that represent a specific customer need. When sorting a category, find the highest and lowest search volume metrics for the past 90 and 360 days. Use search volume growth metrics to understand yearly and quarterly growth. Try to find if growth is related to seasonal trends or consistent upward demand. Sorting by average units sold can give you a sense of overall sales within a category. You can also get an estimate of total units sold in a niche by multiplying the average units by the average price. When sorting, also pay attention to the number of top clicked products metric. Niches include the top products that cumulatively receive 80% of clicks after customers search for a term within a niche. When familiarizing yourself with a niche, sorting by number of top clicked products by both ascending and descending order can help you gauge the overall competition within your selected category. Finally, be sure to sort by average price in both ascending and descending order to get a sense of a category's average price range. Once you've sorted through a category to get a better overall sense of it, apply filters to find niches that fit your needs. Creating a range with the average price filter can help you find relevant options when you have pricing criteria in mind. For example, you can set a range of $25 to $50 and then sort results by search volume in descending order. This can help identify high demand products that fit your pricing model. Sorting again by top clicked products can help find niches with potentially less competition that are trending in demand. If you have a specific target for annualized income when launching a new product, filtering by average units sold and average price can help you understand if a product in this niche could reach your goal. Multiplying average selling price by average units sold can give you an estimate of the annualized opportunity. For example, if you have a target of $30,000 annually for a new product, set your average selling price filter with a $10 minimum and your average unit sold filter with a 3,000 unit minimum. This way, you're only reviewing niches with an average price and sales volume that would equate to your annualized goal, as 3,000 sales at $10 per product would generate $30,000. Specific filter combinations can help you find relevant opportunities. Combining volume change percent over the past 90 and 360 days can help you better understand seasonal trends in a category, for instance. You can also create highly specific filter combinations. Let's say you're looking for niches related to dog products. You have an annualized target of $500,000, and while you're comfortable with competition, you don't want to enter a space that's completely dominated by just a few other brands. To achieve this, you can apply a minimum average price filter of $50 and minimum average units sold of 10,000. Next, create a top clicked products filter between 5 and 15. Now, your list of niches will only include those estimated to hit your annualized goals and with a level of competition you're comfortable with. You can also use Product Opportunity Explorer when you have a specific idea in mind to search for specific related products, features, or categories. Let's say you sell home and kitchen products and want to enter the spice rack space. Searching for spice rack will show you specific niches with distinct customer needs, like magnetic spice rack, wooden spice rack, or expandable spice rack. Finding the different variations of your chosen term can help you speculate about feature-level specifics for new products. Diving deeper into those niches can also help you get a deeper understanding of what resonates with customers. You can also search by features or general characteristics related to your business. For example, if you focus on sustainable products across categories, searching for sustainable can show you a range of related niches, some in spaces you may not have considered before. Once you've found a relevant niche, you can use the search terms section to better understand how customers are searching for and responding to products in this niche. The following strategies can help you identify feature ideas, optimize detail pages, plan inventory, and design targeted ad campaigns. Once you've identified a relevant niche, click it to view more in-depth metrics. Look at search volume, search conversion rate, and click share metrics when you're gauging the opportunity of a niche. Search volume and search conversion rate are key indicators of customer demand. Sort the Search Terms tab by both of these metrics in descending order and look for terms with crossover between high search volume and high search conversion rate. This crossover could suggest highly desired and discovered search terms, and commonalities may speak to overall customer need. Pay attention to clickshare. A high clickshare with low conversion could indicate paid traffic for a term. This could also suggest unmet customer demand, as clickshare is demonstrating customer interest, but conversion shows purchases aren't being made, possibly due to some aspect of the product or listing. Use these metrics to understand trends within niches and categories, identify feature ideas for new products, and to plan and adjust inventory levels based on search traffic. You can also identify go-to market strategies with popular terms that can be used in your listings and advertising efforts. Use the trends section of a niche to understand seasonality. You can look at search volume when determining seasonal trends. Combine this metric with the search conversion rate in the trends graph to compare customer search habits against purchase habits. In this example, we see that search volume spikes at the start of October and that the search conversion rate spikes at the end of this month, indicating that customers are more likely to purchase during this time period. We'd recommend optimizing detail pages, securing inventory, and preparing campaigns prior to the spike in search volume in this example. Low search conversion with a high search volume may indicate product selection in a space isn't meeting customer needs. In this case, use the Insights section of a niche to explore additional metrics like average product listing quality, average star rating, and percent of prime products. High search conversion with low search volume can suggest a brand-dominated niche or an opportunity to break into a less competitive space if search volume shows growth over time. The average price metric can also help you determine seasonality. Use it to understand if search conversion and price drops have a direct correlation. If search conversion only increases when the price declines, consider building this pricing into your margins and pricing model before launching a new product in this space. Average price fluctuation over time can give you a sense of pricing history, which you can use to understand the best time to run deals and drop prices to stay competitive. A high average price along with high search conversion may suggest a less competitive niche or a space where customers are willing to pay a premium price for a popular product. If you create your own products, this could be an opportunity to develop a high-quality offering at a lower price. If you source products, this could be an opportunity to add an offer to top listings within the niche, especially if you notice a high out-of-stock rate. checking the selling partner count, brand count, and product count metrics alongside the search volume metric can help you understand a niche's competition more deeply. High demand with a low partner or product count could represent an opportunity to enter a less competitive space. A consistently low brand count can suggest a niche is dominated by particular brands already active in the space. If you source your products, a low selling partner count could suggest an opportunity to add an offer in this space. High product count with steady growth could suggest a niche is becoming more competitive. If the percent of sponsored products metrics is high and shows growth, this could suggest the space is becoming more competitive. Use these product opportunity explorer strategies to identify relevant niches, perform product research, and optimize your go-to market strategies. This concludes our training on best practices for product opportunity explorer. Thank you and happy selling in the Amazon store.